chaos on this planet is due to the music the musicians are playing that they're forced to play by some who just think of money and don't realize that music is a spiritual language and it represents the people who worry them. When musicians are compelled to play anything, it goes straight to the throne of the creator of the universe, and that is how he sees you according to your music. Because see, music is a universal language, and what you call a musician to play is what goes to the creator as your personal ambassador and your personal nemesis.
Welcome back to another exciting At the Ends of Eras development stream. I am rapidly running out of like unplanned or of like planned work that's like meant to be in this like, I don't know, dev cycle, I would say, iteration of the game. Or at least stuff that I want to do. But okay, let's get this in. Because the main things that are left are basically, just writing more of the stuff. Just writing more, like, story stuff. Specifically for the end game. So what I guess I should do is, not... Or is I won't do that. Now just instead do the other stuff. So let's go to, like, the quests. Let's go to bugs, honestly. That tends to be my go-to. Because we got plenty of bugs. So let's figure out some of these. Alright, and so this one. That one's done. Repairs, dialogue, evaluate a crash. Yeah, let's just fix some bugs. Let's do this one. This one's kind of annoying. Basically, take your time, game. These doors, let's hide this. I guess this? What should I hide? I guess I'll just leave that as it is. Yeah, these doors should have a signal from these. So, untoggled. So does this work? So this should be instant. Let's double check these power things. Does it not? Oh, I see. They're unique power things. So how do these... Toggled auto. Set active. Oh, I see. Oh, wait, no. I don't see. We have this here, auto. Let's go back up to the door. Let's not have that. So I think here. Oh yeah, also. I need to put on my bingo. Greater than 20 minutes late. In my defense, I went to the grocery store, but that doesn't really defend me because we got back from the grocery store and finished eating at like 5:20. Okay, so this should be true. Okay, it is. So then what happens if we do that? We do that. Instant. So instant is true. So there's two of them. And so they should be active now. Wow, there's some hokey jank with this new main menu system. But okay, let's save in here, I guess. Because what it should be is when we start the game, the doors should be open. Let's keep that for now. Okay, it didn't work. Yeah, so these doors are supposed to be activated instantly, and I don't get why they're not, because we saw that the door... So, like, it's the entry doors, right? Dot dot on activated. Oh, it's this? Is this what it is? On activated? What? Entry doors. Oh, okay. Entry doors is the one that has the on toggles. So let's try this again. And let's really, like, dig into it, I guess. Because, yeah, now we know the problem, which is, for some reason, even though it's being passed correctly... It's been activated automatically. Then we emit that. And then we're here because we're adding power. And this should be instant. Okay, open and blah and blah. Debugger broke. Okay, is that in my bingo? We're off to a good start on bingo so far. Okay, so let's just have this here. Because I think this is the only door in the area. What door are we at? Because this is the wrong door. Chunk, dynamic content door. What? So, like, not in anything, it's just door? What? Oh, it's 112. Okay. Wrong thing. There we go. Maybe. Okay. 124 dynamic content entities medium/entry doors. How are these ones getting power? Okay, so that... Okay, now we're getting where we want. So now it's instant. And that should be skipped. Okay, so that's good. And then we do this again. So our current power is 1, and we're getting another one. That's instant. And should open is false. What the, what? No, they are definitely supposed to be open now. What? Oh, I guess I understand why this is the case. Then where the hell do they get the rest of their power? Okay, I see. So this is slightly spoiler stuff, so I'll just warn now. But I won't actually go into the context of it. Okay, so let's do... Okay, that makes sense. Okay, so this should now just work. It doesn't. So these doors should... Alright, let's see this again. Why are these not open? Why is it not instant? Okay, let's check instant. False. Why is instant false? Why is fast forward false? What the fuck are you talking about? Oh wait, I see. Okay, I see. That endgame stuff has some hokey logic to it. Well, I guess it's not even technically endgame anymore. But okay, now it should be instant. And soon I should make it so that that works better. I know what I could do. I could fix sleeping. Since right now, like... If we sleep like this, I think we'll stand. Yeah, first off, the dream has a really awkward, like, thing there. Like, the player should already be standing when that happens. And then if I do this, that's gonna, like, get us out of the dream, but time is now stopped, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, so the day-night cycle is now permanently stopped. Or, well, stopped until we, like, restart the game. Actually, what happens if we sleep again inside the dream? I mean, nothing, but we should also have that disabled. Disable sleeping. So player should be standing when they're in the dream. And then if we exit the dream, the player will start from a standing pose and sit down where they were. Yeah, so they should be lying down and stand up. And also we're now stuck in the dream because I loaded us in here. And also that looks like garbage. The variable previous button was used. Oh, I see. Oh, we know. Previous button equals button. Okay, was this stuff that I did on stream? I think this was stuff I did off stream, maybe. But it's not that important. Or not like a spoiler or anything. Variable text is declared but never used in the block, so I guess I'll just not use it then. Yeah, look at how awful that looks. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is I want to get the wake up working again. Is that the first thing I want to do? Hang on, what do I have planned, actually? The passage on instantly open doors. Wait, did I actually fix that? I completely forgot if I actually even checked if that was fixed. Because I was so distracted by the other bugs. Oh, wait, no, that did work. I guess now I have to double check to make sure. So now it should work. Okay, yeah. So that is complete, and then let's put in features, main menu, let's see, camera should start up close, she's sitting if the player woke up, I mean, that's fine. The real bug is that I'm pretty sure I have it in here somewhere. Animations for Jackie sitting down, I guess? What? Oh, for the interrogation. Okay. And here's the one that I'm complaining about. Players should not go from standing to sitting when walking or waking up on startup. So yeah, let's go back to the player. So the first thing I'm going to do is, so when we enter dream, I'm gonna do like mesh.forceplaystand, I think. So this way we'll solve the awkward problem of the player like shifting from the sleeping pose to the standing pose, like with that, with interpolation. Should be somewhere in here, this one. Alright, I keep forgetting that Jackie's head shrinks slightly because I have that in here as just a slider. Because I could never decide how small Jackie's head should be. Okay, so we go to walk. But yeah, right now the problem is, well, various problems. But the first one is, when we're in the sleep pose, if we just go to walk, it does that very awkwardly. Yeah, because of this. I think this here, well, I don't know what should be there. Maybe this should be at end as well. I don't care that much. Basically, it should just instantly go to here. And I can do that by just doing a force play. Because that just instantly starts that state. Rather than doing the full travel. Alright, so let's see if that fixes that little, like, wonkiness. So I should basically sleep. Eh, good enough. That fixes a little bit of it. Wait, also, I installed PowerShell 7, and fun fact, it doesn't overwrite the original PowerShell, so now I just have two PowerShells. And I'm pretty sure I can't uninstall the old one, because I assume this one will, like, fuck up. Or it just won't be in the correct place for, like, various applications and break everything. What did I change already? I don't think any of these need to be here. I'll have to get used to that, like, thing, but okay. Minor fixes. Okay, because now the bigger one is the sitting going to standing. So that is when we're fading in, awake at. So it's this sit up is broken. So I'm thinking maybe, so what does waking save do? So that just does those. That should be fine. Wake startup. So waking fade in, unlock state.sitting. Okay. So what does sit up do then? Okay, so why? So I think this should be after this then. Like we fade in and then we sit up. I mean, hopefully the game did not, forget. Oh, what should I do about when the player's in a dream? Because right now it just doesn't save until you wake up, but what if the player doesn't know that and they quit the game while they're in the middle of a dream? I should probably have the door, like, automatically save it. Or, like, have the player's saved position. I'll test that later, though. But it still does the janky shit. Why does it do that? Like, it should just play the animation. Just start the animation. Whatever. Let's at least see if this works. It doesn't work. Why does it not work? Is that leave dream? Awake at. So awake at. That does this. So sit up should play this. So force play sleep end. So is there something going wrong? Are these not like applying properly? This is driving me crazy. Okay. But. Hang on. Let's just go to the enemies. Let's go to drown weight. Or are these in like... Oh wait, no, it's in the drowner. So drown weight. Let's just do like a timer. Because these scene tree timers are not very useful. So I'm just going to do instead function ready add. Okay, add file timer, and then we're just going to do a timer.start. Drown check time, and then just function on timeout. Because we'll just have here connect timeout self on timeout. Because I'm tired of having a million errors about this. What the fuck? Wait, does this do timer dot... I know, hang on. Timer dot auto start equals false. Timer dot one shot equals true. And then maybe this will work. Why is it here? Why is it active? Oh wait, it's because I also need to do like set physics process false. I don't need to do that. Why do I need to do this? What does this mean? What node even is this? What? No, this is wrong. The standing ripple? What the f- Hang on. Base mesh. What am I looking for here? Standing ripple. This is a drowner? Well, I guess that makes sense. So basically, if the player... Well, no, it doesn't make any sense. But that's for another day. Why does this not work now? So, like, what is this doing that wasn't done before? I guess first off, let's just do, like... I don't understand it. Oh, I see. There's children of this thing. So what the heck is point check? So let's do, like, Okay, I see. So I can't have the timer in there. So what we need is var c var points equals get children, and then we'll do this here. And then points point check. And this will be our var points array. Okay. Admittedly, now this means that I have just two different things for children, but that's okay. I don't care. So that, like, awkward transition there is also pretty nasty. And then we still have this. So yeah, we're sleeping and then we're not sleeping, even though we should definitely be standing at that point. Like, it's... Let's see. Also, let's go to the illusory room. Or, I guess here. Real, visible, or maybe mum? Something has this real, visible, true, and false, and it's not necessary. And look at that, we have like 15 errors gone. Next will be to figure out what these are. Okay, so I assume this is because the navigation has, like, a cell size, and then the navigation mesh also has a cell size, and they're supposed to be the same, even though it lets you configure them differently. Which is typical. But okay, let's just put that in the to-do list as a thing to fix. But okay, when I wake up, I should start from a lying position and enter a standing or enter a sitting position. Will I do that? No. I started from a standing position, so let's do like fade in or whatever it is. So why does this? First off, I don't think that needs that. Maybe? Let's see if that's the issue, because I think it might be. Because there's some hokey shit with also, like, the force play and the Oh, that's exactly it. It's a deferred, it's like calling it deferred. Okay. And then if I play, yeah, that works kind of. The next step will be to make it so that the player doesn't, like, horrifically fuck up when that happens. But okay, and that's also why the force play here doesn't work. Because we need to do call... Oh wait, no, that's fine there. And then next step will be to make that work, but that'll be, you know, next steps. That looked even worse than it did before, somehow. Like, is this just not working? Yeah, let's go to the animator. So when this happens, and then let's see what would happen after that. Probably play deferred. Okay, so we're sitting up. Great. So that does exactly what I want it to do, where the player wakes up sitting. Though the player should not be... I know why I have the player slightly hovering above the ground, but I don't like it. Sit. Yeah, because we have this 0.005 here. So what if I just did, like... Oh, wait, no. We can do exact. So, like, if we're, like, ready... We can just do here. This will mean that we start the game exactly on the ground. Oh, wait, no, it doesn't. False true. There we go. And then we're going to do that so when we enter the dream... Going to teleport to... True? And this is going to have exact false. So then, honestly, true... Exact... Because, yeah, this way, the player doesn't have to, like, stutter and fall to the ground. And this will only be done in the instances where I know, or can reasonably assume, that the game will actually, like, not look like shit. Or the player will not, like, be clipped into geometry and, like, flung around. Yeah, so now the player has not started on the ground. Very cool. I love that. Well, I guess they... Is it just the player animation is bugged? Like, the animation just starts off the ground? No, she looks like she's on the ground. Okay, so we have this here. We're forcing the player to start. And I assume the debugger will get bored and just stop working at some point. I pressed force play and it didn't work. Okay. Why is that the case? I guess the big thing was, this was supposed to happen after. Let's do like, What should we do? So unlock state.fall. What if I just don't do that until we have this happen? So like, we force play stand and then we have this. Yeah, now that I think about it, that actually would make a lot more sense. Because the issue is we're going from the sitting to standing. So why not go to standing and then unlock the character? So then they're going from standing to standing. Okay, and I'll assume these work until proven otherwise. And we are still hovering above the ground. It still happens. It still happens. Where do I even begin to figure out where in this mess that animation is being triggered? Because it's not being called by play deferred. So I guess it has to be in the unlock state. So when we set the state there. And then if we did, it'd be in like mesh enter state, I think. Where the hell are we? Match current state, match next state, enter state. Because we're going to fall, and that's transition to fall. So that calls deferred travel state. So this should happen after the force play. So we should be, because we should be in the standing animation instantly. And then we should go into the falling animation if we actually need to fall to the ground. And actually, why do I have the player start from there when I could just have, let's do like, so states fall. Oh wait, we already have state.spawning. Okay, and that already does what I want. Okay, so we're in sit up and we do that, and that's good. And then once we activate this, then the question is, why are we entering this state now, for example? It's like, let's do like if state equals state.sitting. Oh wait, we can do like, now let's try to figure out what state are we in previously. Like, do we have our old state? So it's 31. What is 31 in state language? Oh god. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Okay, so we're just in locked. Because I want to go into sitting from here. So let's have that in the main menu. So like, stay sitting after, oh wait, no, that's the wrong thing. Where the hell is the main menu? Okay, stay sitting when starting from sleep. But okay, good enough. Okay, and then we transition to falling, and then we transition to walking. Okay, good enough. Oh, right, this is gonna be a nightmare. Yeah, because every single one of these transitions to a different state. But okay, so we call force play when we enter the dream. So this means that the body should be in the standing state. If we go to body. Oh right, it doesn't expose any of its properties because it's too good for that. And there is no like expression debugging thing here. And then we transition to this. Well, we defer the transition to this. And then we do it again. What we should do is we should have, well, one, we don't need this teleport two here, so we can just set save to transform as true, then fade in, then force play stand, then unlock, rather than trying to do, so this doesn't like set the state, does it? Okay, good, because I think teleport two, no, because that does this. That does the exact same thing. That doesn't fuck with any of this. I mean, that does say that I don't need this, because I can just do the. Yeah, I can just do teleport to there. So what if I just don't have? What if I don't have it unlock the animation? Or like the player's still technically in the sitting state. It just plays them into the animation state. In fact, I could just not have it do that. I could just have it make them sit up. And like it just keeps them in the sitting state. Okay, let's remove all these for now. Why did it not work? The video game is right here. Or wherever it is. Hang on, where's force play? Like, video game. It's right here. This means get up. Okay, so that's an interesting one. Oh wait, no, it's because it's called walk. Alright, so that was the entire issue. I even checked that. Oh. Hang on. Is the hard bug a typo on here? The really hard bug was a small typo. I saw it, but it took my mouse right before I could click it. There we go. And is this unplanned work? I mean, this was unplanned work. Like the specific, this exact bug that I'm working on right now. But it's unlikely we'll get these two. Well, it's unlikely we'll get this one. This one's almost given. But okay. So now, let's make sure I see it now. Great. In fact, what I should have is anytime there's, so like, let's go to force play. Oh, I guess it, I don't even know how to get that then. Okay. Let's just do like set date, state dot. Or honestly, state.ground would be nicer, probably. And eventually I'll have to figure out why all of the UI starts. Did it fucking not work again? What does that mean? Because it's, we start from the standing pose. We are in the standing pose when this happens. Hang on. Start from the ground pose. Why is it there? Because if I did this, this'll just work. I think I have to split out the gameplay logic from the animation logic. Yeah, because that looks perfect. So we need to have set play state dot ground, or enter state. Because then we'll do set state here, and this will have a function at the top. And this will do all of our actual gameplay logic. Without doing this mesh.enter state. In fact, we also do this. So now when we enter the dream, instead of doing the, we just force the player to be standing, set the state to be standing, in gameplay logic. Do not fiddle with the animations otherwise, because it's, because that's all I want. I want the player to be standing when they wake up. Good enough. So then the next thing to do would be to put that actually on the ground. So where's the world? Do I have the dream as a separate world? I do. Good. That way I don't have to actually get in the thing. So the teleport reference. So this should be exactly against the ground. In fact, we could set the gameplay logic to be in the fall state. So let's do that. So that way the player is falling, but they don't have the animation. So that should seamless. That should make it even more seamless, even if we're ever so slightly above the ground. In fact, I could do that for everything now. Or any instance where I don't want the actual falling animation to show. Okay. How did I fuck it up again? What is... So it must be something to do with... So does state.fall do anything? So if we have mesh dot in here... Okay, I see. Hold item... So those should be okay. So let's print. Where's our next state stuff? We're gonna have this. Where's exit? Oh, that makes sense. Okay. That's fine. Enter green. And we'll print debug gamer. I meant to write gamer. That's kind of impressive, actually. But how? Does it fuck it up? Okay. Let's try setting it to ground and see if the ground actually just works. Because I may need to do something where, like, I set the... Where, when I teleport the player, I do a physics check and just make absolutely sure they're on the ground and then just set that as the ground. Because now it's going to go from ground to fall to ground again, I'm pretty sure. Oh wait, no, it doesn't. Weird. Yeah. Okay. So that works. Now the fucking button is broken. What? What does that mean? What did I do? How does that not work? It's like, are you kidding me? Okay. The fucking button broke. Video game. Can interact. So like so if action is item pressed, dialogue item, and interactable. Okay, let's see if this works. Okay, so it's just not doing anything in here. Like, does the input work? When the fuck did I set this? When did I break this? Is it just from reloading the game? Okay, let's try again. So can I talk to this? I can't talk to that. And I can't leave. What does this mean? What did I change with set? Hang on. What did I change? So we have enter state, set state. Is it because the unlock? Okay, I think I know what it is. Also, music died. Is that on the bingo? I don't think it is. And I almost forgot what I was playtesting once, but it wasn't that I forgot what I was testing. I forgot that I had checked or what the result of the test was. Okay. So yeah, it's this unlock right here. In fact, we can do unlock state.ground. So that should be let's do like I guess let's just do this. Like I don't need this. So enter dream. Because that's what okay, so that's all that unlock does. And I should also make sure, then, that when we start the game from the sleeping position, it still works. Okay, so that works just fine. Okay, so now that actually looks good. And then this... A-okay. And then that works. Oh, but we can't sit up from here. So that is, like, exit... green? So we fade out, awake at. Doesn't awake at do this already? Because it does a teleport too. Okay, so let's do unlock state dot sitting. And then we sit up. And that should work. Or maybe, actually, it'd probably be better to do this. And then we unlock the sitting. And if that doesn't work, we can always set the state to whatever it needs to be set to. Okay, because that works. This is broken again. How the game froze? What the fuck? What? The game. I hate video games. One thing I'll think didn't work out. Okay. The funny line. We could get a bingo this way. Well. Nah. Probably not. Too many situational things on there. Okay, so I assume it was a bug with the fade. Like, I must have entered this while the UI was fading out. Oh my god. The fade out didn't trigger. And then we're sitting. Okay. Enter state. State.sitting. Set process input through. Did I accidentally forget a Oh, I know. I understand. No, I don't. When we enter the dream... let's put all this back, actually. Because I thought I've removed a fade in. So when we leave the dream... What did I change that shouldn't have been changed? I don't even see leave dream here. Oh wait, no, I do. Okay, I'm stupid. It was a fade out. I thought it was a fade in. And I was like, oh, that's redundant with the thing. Okay. Now that actually seems pretty good. Well, Yeah, going from here to sitting, that's fine. Okay, so now what we need is when the player is in the sitting state, like locked and sitting. How do we determine that? I guess that would be... So yeah, we have this wake startup. Sit up. And then I guess from here. We could then cue the. Because we're actually going to be in the spawning state here as well, regardless of whether we're sleeping or not. Because we don't actually enter this state. And then when we're in state, dot. Spawning. Walk. Okay, so let's do mesh.body.getCurrentNode equals walk after if this else return state.sitting. Maybe. So this should just get rid of some of the annoying, like, bugs. Oh. That looked nice, but it was just my sticks drifting. Though it does kind of speak to, I could do that for this, but okay. Then that. Wait, I completely forgot to check the thing that I was checking. Okay. Now we can go to the bingo card. Check that. Because I needed to test to make sure at the start of the game. Okay, so not quite. So that should be here. I think. Let's see what the, let's actually double check that that ready works the way that I think it's supposed to. So yeah, we should have this state dot spawning here. In fact, we can now set this guaranteed there. Because wake startup should just do, yeah. Oh wait, no, we don't need this. Do we? No, sleeping should be what like does that. Yeah, I don't think we need that at all. That probably doesn't actually do anything, though. Well, I guess it does. Why is that? What? So we went from fall to spawning, then spawning to locked, then locked to ground, ground to fall, fall to ground. Hang on. I don't understand. Okay. So how much stuff do we have? So we go from fall to spawning, so that is in, well, honestly, we could just have that, we could just have the player start in spawning. So like state equals. It's like the current state should probably just be S dot spawning. And that way we don't have to deal with that. And then like set state or like function ready. Yeah, because we don't need this here. And then here we have notification, start lock, what? Like, the player does not need to be locked here. In fact, I don't think we need either of these. Well, I guess we do want the player's input locked. No, but they're already in the a locked-ish, or they're already in the locked state. I guess I could just do set input process false here. Because then when we do the spawning, so after all this, set process input through. So that way we remove that one. Because then we have this underscore resume, so that's when we actually set the state again. And then we have the fall to ground. Okay. So now it should just go to the sitting state. Because basically, the player won't actually advance. Oh wait, no, the player does advance time. What? Invalid get time and base dictionary. State dot data dot time, but it should be. What? We go to S dot spawning. Yeah, we got time here. Honestly, maybe the player's camera rig should be the only thing that does this. Because I can have the player completely still. Actually, I don't think... How does the wardrobe work? Does this get the camera? No, that's the wrong thing. What is this, actually? Okay, yeah, I need wardrobe UI. Okay. That does that. Oh, I see. The player is now not properly set up. Actually, I don't even understand this. So, why is our data empty? Because we should have player current state. State should be in here somewhere. Where's current? Oh, I see. Current is 46. And 46 has that. So that should be fine. Oh wait, this is supposed to be current.data? What the hell is this supposed to be? Oh, I see. I still gotta do all the stuff. Hang on, let's go to the player. Because, yeah, we don't need this anymore. We can just set state. State.spawning. So that's still correct. And eventually I can come back to this and make it so the player can actually, like, move. Or, like, so the player animates when they're doing this. I guess I could just make it so... I don't know what I'd do. Yeah, I'd certainly like some animations here. But let's play. Okay, so we're playing... Okay, so we do that. I miss all the things that I had to sacrifice for this. I know what to do. We'll do player... global.getPlayer.spawn. Or, like, enter game. Or, it should just be, like, set states. I guess this will be fine. Basically, instead of the spawning stat... Because what I thought was going to happen was, the video game was going to work, but that isn't what it is. Enter dream. Leave dream. Let's just do, like, function start game, or whatever I just put there. Okay, and then here, start game, UI unpause. I don't know, just state.ground, who cares? You can jump for a frame. Because after all, it's literally one frame. There we go. So now, when you start the game, you're actually here, and then you can just walk around. And then if we sleep... We're here. Beautiful. And then we can leave. And rolling brings out the gun for some reason. Sleeping should not bring out the gun. Okay, and then let's try now. Because now the player should be standing. A-okay. Beautiful. And then the next steps will be to make the UI hidden by default. Because that looks hideous when it does that. So let's just put that in all that stuff. But let's do print debug, print stack. Okay, those are the only things there, and then... Control backspace doesn't work in the new version of PowerShell, that's cool. I like that they, you know, it's always like two steps forward, one step back. Okay. Animation fixes. So this was fixing all the little glitches that were making me mad. So stay sitting when startup is complete. What are the other bugs? Make Jackie's hair look acceptable under her hat. Okay, where is... Sometimes the game just starts up as a slideshow. Player should be... Okay. That one's good. So those were the two things I fixed. So particularly near ledges or slopes. Oh yeah, and that's already fixed. So we need disable resetting, disable rescues. I guess for those I can have... Let's have a area. Dream zone. Okay. Okay, so this should have, I guess, environment overrides. So, like, we'll have, like, wind reduction. Custom fog, maybe, like, a white with, like, a... Like that. Maybe some cool, like, weird colors. Didn't I do this already, actually? Oh, wait, no, I just did it with the, So, yeah, the reflection probes here have some stuff. This will add our other stuff. So we will not show the sun. I guess we will override the music. No combat, close cam. No rescue available. And visited stat will be the dream. And that should remove some of this stuff. And then I can add extra stuff. And actually, we probably should be allowed to save in here and then just have it so that when we are in there, the day-night cycle stops. That's interesting. Why are we in here? Oh, wait, no. I see why. It's because this is wrong. It should do that. There we go. Now we're back to normal. Oh, yeah, it's an unshaded thing. So we actually should do... We should probably just do completely black, then. Or maybe, like, almost completely black? Maybe, like, a deep purple. Or deep blue. Let's constrain this a bit more, even. Like... How wide is this box? So we go to, like, 40 to 45. So let's do... I guess 35. And that won't show up until we do this again. Oh, right. I just soft locked myself. Okay, let's get a player. So when the player is in the dream, so can sleep. Bar S equals, if not S, turn false. I guess a hack that I could do. I know what to do. Now let's do like good ground. Bar good ground equals this. Oh wait, no. If not ground, return false. Let's just make a big old mess of statements. So we need ground, and the collider is not in the group dynamic, and blah blah blah, and not ground dot collider. Oh wait, no. We should probably just have like get and not. Well, how do we do this? Get my int pass. Let's do like if get or like bar scn equals get free dot current scene, and then that's where we're gonna do this dream current scn. And now the world script. Environment, so apply environments. So we need function get environment. Get top environment. So if not, or if environment overrides dot empty, return self. So this would just be like node else return environment overrides 0. And actually I just realized this could be dictionary, because I think these environment overrides because they're pEnvironment.dictionary. Remove environment Okay, so let's get the environment overrides in here. Get, so like, override. So yeah, we have apply override, overrides. And we'll have like, object self. Or like node. Get top environment. So this is dot node. Okay, there we go. And now we can fix the player. Because we can do this get environment dot is in group. So let's do if scene.has method get top environment return scn.get else. Return scene. Okay. So now we should be, yeah, we're not allowed to sleep in here. Oh wait, no. Yeah, okay. So yeah, we're not allowed to sleep. We can't sit down though. So now we have a couple of these fixed. We have disable rescues, disable saving. Make the time say blah. Oh wait, and we also fixed this one. Disable sleeping. Wait, what? I was getting a bit ahead of myself. Okay. So disable resetting. Sets. Eventually, at some point, the reset bar... I should probably just make it so that when you sit, there's an input. Let's just put that in, like, features. Make sleeping just another prompt when sitting. Not a button you hold down. Yeah, because now reset bar, so this here needs to do something with this. So if the player.ui.gaming.blah, or not player.anreset. Get top. Alright, get environment. Okay. Function can reset. Cool. Return not get environment is in group dream. This makes things a lot easier to just have an environment in the group dream. Okay, so now, yeah, now I can't do that. Where am I? Oh, I see. It feels like the fog doesn't get... Or it feels like the fog gets a lot darker a lot quicker than it's supposed to. Like, or at least, it feels like it doesn't have as much of an effect up close. Oh well. We now cannot reset. And we should soon disable the saving and quitting. How did I even save down here? Because now I'm stuck. Oh right, because I slept. Because, yeah, I think this actually doesn't save. Yeah, that doesn't save. Though, actually, it probably should. It should just not save your position. See, I think what I'd prefer is save dialogue, but... Yeah, so actually what I want here is to save the dialogue, track exit position, and use that for door. Enter dream. Let's just do like var x equals Oh wait, no, we already have this. We have sleep position here. Yeah, so that's global transform. And we should also do if get environment.is in group dream print debug no dreams in dreams breakpoint. So that should fix that. And then we can just have, let's go to the dialog viewer. And let's go to the medium dream. So we've got plenty of dreams there. Okay, location equals dream. How do I, dialog entry location. How did I make it so that this doesn't save its dialogue? Like save checkpoint. Oh, we have skip save. And the music died again. In fact, let's raise that a smidge. Okay, so that's all well and good. Mostly. I do sometimes have to modify the engine, but that's really, I guess that doesn't really count as, like, game logic. Let's teleport back up to here. So yeah, the game should now be able to track my position when I save and enter a dream. And it should, so if I, like, did this. I don't know how it doesn't save. Wait, actually, let's save. Let's go into here. I see. I've never been able to. I've never started the game in here, and that makes sense because it doesn't save there. How did I do that again? How did I do that? Because I need to undo that. I guess I can just do like end dialogue or like just function end and see where the save is. Because I could have sworn we did some sort of save checkpoint here. Maybe it's in the player? Yeah, we have this in, dialogue exit. If save and ground. So exit is mostly always true. I guess I just do it here. and then see what exactly is happening to make it not save. Yeah, whenever I have to make C++ changes, I have to recompile the engine, which unfortunately means, like, for some of them, like, if I'm editing, like, the node header, that'll be, like, a full 20 minutes of changes. Okay, so that's good. So let's see what our exit state is. State 1, stand calm. So let's go to the player, on dialogue exit, or on dialogue, oh wait, no, on dialogue exited. I guess I'll try that again, see what I was missing. Okay, so we got that. How does it... Wait, what? The player's not in here. Oh, it's because we're doing on dialogue exited anim. But that should do the same thing. Okay, because we got all these. And I'm pretty sure we're definitely saving. Yeah. Okay, so we have exited anim. And then we should have save as true. So save. And ground. Oh, we don't have a ground. Yeah, it's glacial to rebuild Godot. Thanks. So I didn't even realize that this was a completely unrelated issue. I guess that's... Okay, then what I should do is make it so that when you, like, cross the threshold, it saves. Let's just put a little save zone. Just be like, area, save zone. So I'm gonna do just like that. Well, let's do a big wide. I don't know what I can do. We'll just make a square around this. Well, if I'm doing this, then it's kind of weird that it's like not actually a square. Okay, so now there's that. And that should save I guess let's save here. And then it should save when we get out of here. But I didn't even realize that talking to the medium doesn't actually automatically save the game. I guess it should, I know what it should do. Even if it doesn't save the player's position, it should still do else global.save async. What's the path here? Oh, I see. Wait, actually, I don't see. Oh, wait, I do see. Why did I make it so weird? Save game. So now it'll at least save the progress in the dialogue, even if it doesn't save that the player has actually, like, done it. And also, technically now, the game... What should I do? I guess that's fine. And the player should wake up where they were last awake. There we are. Like it never happened. And we should also have it so that if the player's in a dream, that stops the game as well. So I guess we could do... We have here the entered and exited. So if I go to the world, or I guess I can do... I'm trying to think what I want to do with the saving and loading. Okay, track exit position, use that for the door, save dialogue, that's good. Make the time save blah. When starting, make sure day night is stopped. Or when starting in the dream. This isn't really that big of a deal. And I'll also put this one at lower. Like this one, lower. Make sure Jackie's hair looks acceptable under her hat. Also lower. This one, I'm ambiguous on that one. Okay, let's say that these ones are going to be now less important than the other ones. Climbing into crouch size area kills you. Honestly, well... There's so many bugs. Let's get some of these tested then. I'll save what I have. Some dream fixes. Okay, so let's go back to here. So one of the bugs that I saw was asking Armstrong about Activate the Medium show's notes about Bashar instead, which basically means there's a quest, and I want to ask him about the quest. So he gives us a whole bunch of stuff to say. I see. So now I should get all of these. Debugger broke. Okay, so now we can talk to him again. So let's use a note. So we're gonna ask about the medium. I'm supposed to have a task to activate the medium. I already completed this? Oh, I did. Okay. Okay, and now it has the correct things. Oh, wait, no. It might not. Because I already did the quest, so that, that didn't have the place associated with it. But honestly... Hang on. Bugs... Main menu, laser on hand and starting. Because there's going to be a whole bunch of things that are because that's supposed to be hidden on the first frame, but it's sort of janky because of the way that I've set up my stuff. But okay. Jackie the Coats Girl. Oh wait, hang on. Now the point is, use a note. This, okay, there we go. Basically that was because in this introduction quest, activate the, these needed to be above the notes for Bashar, which is a place. Because... Yeah. The tasks are more important than the place, basically. So it's completed. Honestly, it'll take me a while to figure that one out. Make UI, make collectible UI smaller and further to the bottom right. Also, just a minor thing. Notes about Bashar and his full name contradict. I removed those. Shopkeeper's dialogue is out of date. Dialogue after the medium's been prepared. Note dialogue about Bashar. Armstrong moment, whatever else. So this. I should recommend more language. The job. Also less important, I think. Okay, I'm Jackie. Pleased to meet you. Welcome to my shop, Jackie. Whatever brings you so far from your home to our modest city? So I'm here to see the medium. Oh yeah, the dialogue thing? That is, that's my own, plugin, basically. So I made a little syntax highlighter, and then I made an importing script for Godot. It's basically like regular expressions to do line-by-line parsing. Ah, Brawlny Morta. The medium of Brawlny. I do not believe the machine has worked in some years. I've talked with that gentleman Armstrong about it. Apparently it just needs some missing parts. So Armstrong has roped you into repairing that contraption. Well, of course, I need to use it. So you do. But let's put aside such matters. I doubt you came here to have me talk your ears off. You probably came here to buy something. I'll see what you have. Alright. Thank you. I hope you found what you were looking for. Let's see, so what do you sell? Mainly elixirs, death nets, flags, and other useful items. Yeah, that all makes sense. I think his dialogue's reasonably good. It is slightly now out of date with the with Armstrong's new stuff. Make it more consistent with Jackie's behavior toward Armstrong. Oh wait, the other thing that I was meaning to say, or the other thing I was meaning to make sure of, was where is that shop? Let's save and quit here. Let's go to the shops. Oh, it's already an intro. I already did the thing that I wanted to do, which was to move it from the shops folder to the intro folder. I just couldn't figure out where it was. But okay. So we've already have... I'm sure I got it working, actually. I found a capacitor for him. Okay, yeah, I already did that. Okay, Jackie's feet don't stay planted when idle. This is one that's kind of annoyed me. I think it's something to do with the, like, frame rate that animations are imported in. But admittedly, this probably should be a lower priority. Well, yeah, because you can see there, it's just like, why? Why are her feet moving like that? Because if we went to Blender, I don't want to go to Blender though, that'd be a lot of work. But if we did, hypothetically, we would see that they're planted, because it just uses IK, like it's directly there. And let's also hide this laser by default. I think? Is this what I actually hide? Maybe I hide the whole gun? Okay. We can set this to visible, and we can also hide the laser itself. So I guess what we should actually do is this should be invisible by default. Or maybe it should be like set state like no weapon? Okay, yeah, that's all good. And that also wasn't the bug. Okay. So let's go to our core movement. So this should have some animation rules. So what if we did, like... Because if I do, like, 15 here... Because that's what this is by default. And then this, like, bobbing gets significantly worse if we do that, I think. Yeah, we can see there it's not great. Let's bring this back up to 60. And we need some sort of... We need to tweak the optimization. So let's do like max linear error of like 0.01. It leaves something to be desired. But I don't know if I'm going to be able to fix that in a reasonable amount of effort. So let's just bump it down to just something that I could, that makes the game worse but not unplayable. Okay, you should attract attention if you go without covering your hair. Honestly, this one's good, but also there. Wish our gate guard should have something to say if you can't find all the specters. Oh, I already have that. I was like getting ahead of myself and like thought he didn't have any hints. And also, too many of these little guys. Is four. I'll do some gems instead. Because basically I want this here so the player knows to look for this. Well, I started the game in Godot 3 and I don't want to spend several weeks, because basically I did actually try migrating to Godot 4 and it'd be possible, but it'd be several weeks, and plus I'd have to make more modifications to Godot 4 to like redo some of the changes I've made to Godot 3 that aren't in there. Though funny enough, some of the changes that I've made are actually just things that are now in Godot 4, like this skybox isn't an actual like texture, it's like a shader, which I had to do in a hacky way in Godot 3, but Godot 4 just has skybox shaders. And also, Godot 4 has like an abysmal animation importer. Because like, you have to like manually check every single animation to say yes, don't delete my custom tracks. And then you have to specify a file, like a file path for every single custom track on every single animation. And it's like, in any game, it's like, obviously I want to save the custom tracks. Like, I don't understand why Godot doesn't do that by default. And they made it even more annoying in Godot 4 because you have to specify the path of every single individual custom track. Or I guess every single animation, and then the custom tracks are just on the animation. Like, I feel like it's just something where it's not implemented very well because it has to create a bunch of files for you. And so instead of fixing that problem, they just make it like, oh, of course it deletes all of your work by default. Like, why wouldn't it delete all your work? You gotta read the manual. But okay. Oh, wait, I should actually, like, test some things. So this done. add alternate routes up to Byro's farm. Yeah, I guess I can do that. Because that was basically just... It's annoying to have to walk up this exact route every time. So I want to add, like, probably just a few rocks up this way. Let's do that. So that would be Terrain Byro. And this song feels a bit perceptually louder. Yeah, let's throw some rocks just in here. Yeah, I'm assuming it's because it has to create the animation tracks for you. So it's like, oh, well, let's turn this bug into a feature by making it so you specify, you know, which animation or where you want to save those animations instead of just like, you know, because there's well, I guess there is some reason that you would save an animation without saving custom tracks. Because you can make, like, animation packs, but it's... I don't know. Yeah, they would just I think most of them will just implicitly make, like, animation files wherever it needs to in order to, like, save your custom tracks. I'll just throw some rocks in here. So I think the player could get up here with all this. So I think if the player... Oh yeah, the player can get up here now. So yeah, now the player doesn't have to walk all the way around that way. And then eventually I should do some more stuff in this area to just make it look more interesting. Probably more ruins, more little town bits there. Let's say that's done. Charity or humanitarian aid group provides the wind generator kits. Nah, I'm fine with how they are. Type 1 game from that farm that I'm running it. Let's go to that. So that's the gate guy. Man, Byro. Byro doesn't react when I mention the superstructure. Okay, yeah, let's do that. Because this is basically a side quest for, let's go to the quests. Arena. Byro. So if I talk to the guy up here, there's still that weird, like, if I do one of these jumps really fast, it sometimes comes out, like, at, like, 1 foot. Okay. Help, monsters have taken over my home. I suppose I'll do what I can. If you clear them off my farm, I would be in your debt. Okay. Oh, right. This is the only thing in the game with a dialogue, or one of the only items in the game with a dialogue circle still. I should fix that while I'm here. Did I take care of all of his specters? I guess I did. Yeah, he looks fine. Well. Okay. There are still monsters roaming the farm. Let's see if I can take care of them. Oh, there is one. Not very threatening. Okay. You've saved my life, thank you. It is so terrible the scoundrels released these creatures into my home. Someone released them? Who? The village. They want to take over my farm. Those are serious allegations. Why would they do that? Well, a few months ago, I finally decided to stop giving them food for free. We are in the modern world, I say. I want to work for more than nothing. It has not gone well. I fear they will not stop until poor Byro is dead. Perhaps I can talk to someone. I'm sure this is just a misunderstanding. Oh no, I could not ask a young woman to fight my battles for me. If we're counting those creatures, I've already fought a battle for you. Oh no, you're right. If you can find out who did this and bring them the justice, I will reward you. Okay. So with that quest, let's save here as, like, Byro. It's supposed to look kind of abstract, vaguely like an airplane engine. Though, admittedly, there's not actually any relationship to airplanes. Well, not much in the game. Yeah, it gets less abstract as it as you get extensions to it. But it also gets way too big, I think. Oh, yeah. So basically, long story short, that quest leads the player down into here. And so, given the ordering and stuff, I want to make sure that this works. This podium seems to be missing something. So that should have... That should not have those dialogue circles, but that's okay. Now let's do... Yeah, I guess that's a good thing to think about. Because another reason I designed it that way instead of just a circle is so that way the player can mentally map it from like a... Or like get a more specific idea of the proportions. You know, like they'll know like, oh, I've used up a third of my stamina. Or I guess technically like a sixth. So what would that be? This would be a sixth, I think. Or no, a third. Yeah, because basically it does two full revolutions. Yeah, now that you mention it, it does actually imply a snowflake. Okay, do you have any news? Have you found who unleashed those terrible beasts? Alright, so the big note would be this one, that there's a massive structure deep in the caves marked by a skull. So let's see what that one is, or if I can put that one somewhere in here. Podium. Would it be called a podium? I think there must be a better word for it, but I'll think of it. Is it a... or hive? Massive structure. What is it called? Oh, Cave 137 Podium. Well, I guess the player... Let's do this. Note. Cave 137 podium. Where global task is active. Unwelcome visitors. And tower. Not stats. Biro / give tablet. I found the most bizarre structure underground. I guess I should say structure underground nearby. Or near here. Massive black skull. He produces a black, small tablet with the exact same emblem, her skull. So what on earth is this? I completely forgot, so I constantly had to copy and paste quotes from a file because I don't have open and close quote characters, but I had actually added them as like shortcuts and then just forgot about it. I mean, this would be a good opportunity for one of these little contextual dialogue bits, because this isn't actually directly related to this. Yes, so let's just put here, let's do this here. Okay. It looked like some sort of hive. the massive black skull above the entrance. Okay, so now I should be able to kind of just fast track this quest by going to Byro, going to the spooky cave, then going back to Byro and asking him about the spooky cave. I mean, technically you can even double fast track him by just getting the spooky tablet and then going to him in the spooky cave. Right, he's no longer on his roof, he's out here. You have any news? Have you found who unleashed those terrible beasts? Certainly found something. Found an ominous structure underground near here. It looked like some sort of hive for those specters. It had a massive black skull above the entrance. Oh no, I suspect I have something for you. He produces a small tablet with the exact same skull. What on earth is this? It's a lucky charm. So is this the same skull? Yes. You said this is a lucky charm? Why on earth would these give you luck? He shrugs. There's luck to be found in death. I suspect it will be, thank you. Oh yeah, and also, the dialogue between these always gets kind of awkward because these are just like completely isolated asides. Oh yeah, also, at some point I want to get this width down. I'll do that at some other point. I think that's all I can think worth mentioning. In the meantime, I found a stick to defend myself. Okay. So now we can just noclip back here. So yeah, the big spooky place. Because now we have... Oh, wait, no, okay. I thought that my inventory had stopped working. But no, it's just I was pressing the wrong button. Okay, so we have spooky skull tablet. There's also some weird edge, like, I don't know if there's like vertices that aren't like properly aligned or like edges aren't properly aligned, but there's like a little flickering. Okay, so let's get this. This podium seems to be missing something. You place the tablet in the podium. It fits. You immediately notice a change. Why did the dialogue do that? Okay, but now we can do that. We can go. So this place is basically intraversible right now. So that'll all have to be like renovated again. And also there should probably be a faster route from here to here. Well, I guess it's not that bad, but well, if the player's walking, it could be annoying. I found what was bringing those specters to your home. It was that tablet. It controlled some sort of hive down in the caves. Really, but I only have the tablet. But I had the tablet for years. Why would they only appear now? I'm interested in finding out myself. Okay. That's... So this is... Okay, that's fine. Gives you a bottle with some sort of tonic. Good for you. Interesting, thank you. If I find anything more about this hole with her, I'll let you know, alright? Yes, that would be good. Okay, so now... I have an extra little thing. So this makes it more obvious that it's not a snowflake. Yeah, now I'm thinking, what do I actually want for this? Because it gets too big, so if I did, like, item, stamina, up, I think I can do 5 more of these. Yeah, it takes up, like, the entire bottom of the screen. And also, it looks a little bit too much like a tattoo or something. Doesn't really match the rest of the UI. Do this now. Goodbye, stamina ups. Okay. So now we need what do we need? I guess... Oh wait, his dialogue about the skull title is also wrong if we've already been to the structure. Oh wait, yeah. Okay, that's correct as well. So we need note, skull tablet. So... Note, Byro Skull Tablet, where this global stat is existing, so if the task is completed, otherwise, let's do, like, not stat A137/podium. Every day I regret adding this question mark here. I didn't need it. So this, and then otherwise. And actually, let's do... global stat, or like stats. Byro/skull tablet. Wise, it looked nearly identical to the... actually, this simplifies things. I can just do this here, where we have note this. Oh wait, this is the wrong thing. This should be 5137. Like, direct. Where this is true, and... Oh yeah, where all of these are true. And global stats, A137/podium. There we go. So I found an ominous structure. It had a massive black skull above the entrance. It looked nearly identical to the tablet you have in your room. Okay. above the door was a black skull, nearly identical to that tablet you have in your room. Let's see, the lucky charm? Why on earth would this give you luck? Let's say that. Okay, so above the door was a black skull nearly identical to that tablet you have in your room. Oh, you think it's related? I have absolutely no doubt. I think I need to take it with me. Back to the hive and see. But but you might be right. I'll go. He produces a tablet. Oh, whoops. Accidentally activated APL mode. That's what alt comma is in APL. Okay. Because I need to use left alt. Which I think is actually, I think right alt is the same as just control alt. Yeah. Okay, it's a good luck charm. Why on earth would this give you good luck? Okay. And then he produces the tablet. Okay. There we go. Also, we should have this here as like a and not global stats. In fact, this makes this much easier. So I can just do that. And this will be like get tablet. There should be I'm gonna put these names here so that way I can change these stats at some point. Huh, it feels like there's stuff that's missing from here. Oh, I see. It's because I had changed. Okay. Oh, wait, no. Okay, that's fine. Weird. Yeah, I thought I wrote more dialogue for him. Okay, so I guess that takes care of my issues with them. So his dialogue about the skull tablet is also wrong if I've already been to the structure, because now that merges with that. Podium should not have a dialogue circle. Skull tablet should has a dialogue circle. Restructure to use go to phase. Do I guess I could do that. That'd be good. People should come by to talk to buyer to show. This one, I'll say honestly, well, I don't even know if I want to do that. This one though, important, but not that important. Yeah, let's do these ones. Admittedly, actually it is important, but it's just, it's gonna be hard. But okay, let's fix Byro's stuff at the very least. So yeah, this is the thing that I no longer need. How do I do this? Static body? Interactive. Skull tablet. Examine, so this would be like skull. Enabled wisp visible. I guess there is no wisp. Okay, so if has node wisp, wisp equals get node. Set show wisp. If inside tree and wisp. Okay. So this is now dialogue bit. And this will be, I think, layer 13. Is this skull tablet, like, not properly aligned? Oh, it isn't. There we go. Let's actually move this up a little bit. There we go. So now we have that, and then we can go to cave 137. Do the same thing to this podium. Yeah, let's do static body, podium interact. What's the main speaker here? Oh, it's just, okay, that's fine. And I guess this should have a wisp. So this will go right there. This will be right here. So we should have wisp visible. Custom entry, podium. So does this thing not have any? How does this evil podium work? When I put the key in, it should do, okay. It just gets recall group enemies kill. Shape. then we put this right there. I think that should work. Remove item, call group, keep 137 locked. So why is this? Okay, cave 137 locked. And so that means that this no longer needs to be here. Let's try this again. Gosh. I was like crossing my feet and hurt my toe. I should probably make that fade in faster. But oh well. Alright, let's no clip. Oh wait, no. I need to do new game. Yeah, I should make the fade in a bit faster. Okay, so let's do that, just so I don't have those in my inventory anymore. And all I need to do, I don't actually need to test the quest again for now. I'll just zoom up here and make sure that I can examine the item and that it works as it should. Oh wait, accidentally. Okay, there we go. So now we can examine this. There's a strange skull tablet. The owner of this house can probably tell you more once the specters have been driven off. And I should eventually have that also be a thing I can change. Like specters, because specters is a very specific name that the people in the area give to those creatures. So until the player actually gets those, you shouldn't be there. Okay, so now we have topics, unwelcome visitors, Byro. Monsters have done that. Now we have Byro, and we have tasks, so it's no longer in topics, which is good. Oh wait, no, I don't need to do that. We need to go this way. Okay, so now podium seems to be missing something. Okay, so now we should have. There's a strange man on Byro's, or a strange tablet on Byro's table marked with a skull. I met a distressed man on the roof of his home, being harassed by monsters. There's a massive structure deep in the caves, marked by a skull. There's a podium with a slot for something. Okay, so now, oh wait, I can't actually get out of here vanilla yet. I'll just say that'll be for the next thing. Okay, so those are all good. Let's go up to quests. So an unwelcome visitors, do I actually have the Move shops into the cave. Warn the player about the fence sections. I already did that. But let's say, like, make the cave out of the hive easier. And then, like, also make the cave from the basin up to Cerulean gear possible again. So, like, add missing sections. Okay, yeah, the player could use a motorcycle or scooter. And I guess I can look up, what would I do with that? I'd say like a 1933 BMW motorcycle. Does that even exist? Yes, it does. What if we did off-road motorcycle? What were people using in this day and age? A 1933 Harley. Okay, yeah, let's start getting reference for these things. So we need to go back to Jack for concept art. I'll say vehicles. Oh, I already have that. Vehicles, motorcycle. So yeah, I think, well, a night. Then again, this doesn't really have any off-road looking things. This kind of does. Because nowadays you would use a dirt bike for this sort of area. It's interesting. It looks almost like a bicycle with how like small the tires are and like how thin the engine is. Admittedly, I should probably implement the gameplay first. Now this would be a bit too, like, this would be a bit too technically advanced, or, like, sort of out of sync with it. Though it does look cool. Because I do think, I wonder, would there be any benefits to riding a vehicle like this in such a, like, desert environment, like a rocky area? Because you would have a larger wheel. Then again, the suspension's really what you'd want. Because dirt bikes handle tough roads just fine. Let's see. So, yeah, it'd be like this is the modern. So when did motorbikes start being this shape? I guess the big thing is like the almost sort of scissor shape for the entire bike, since this entire assembly here is connected by, I think, a hinge and the suspension, which is part of what gives them so much suspension. Yeah, like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm thinking more of realism from the perspective of aesthetic interest, because having just like a, I don't know, I wouldn't like the aesthetics of this going up a hill, basically. So I'm trying to think what I could do to push this into that similar direction. So I'll actually get that, this image. Because yeah, I'm thinking an older style motorcycle, but it just has this, like, interest, this weird back assembly, or something like it. Because the game is very anachronistic with its technology already. I guess now my thinking is, how do I make something that looks like it could actually go up these hills, but still looks not just like a dirt bike? Where did I put it? Vehicles? There it is. Where? Oh, this is E. There we go. Okay, so let's get Creed out. So I'll do like a little bit of drawing. So yeah, it'll be certainly a challenge to rectify like this design and this design. Especially since this line here is a very defining trait of both of these. And this one, I guess it's almost the opposite shape. Oh. Let's bring these into Creed up. Let's see. I don't know what that was. I think it was just a single-wheeled, I don't know what you'd call it. Let's do like 2,000, 2,000. Yeah, I guess they just call it like a one-wheeled motorcycle or something. Hmm. At this point, it'd be a lot cheaper to just get a motorcycle. Like, you could get a motorcycle with a sidecar so you don't have to worry about tipping over. But then again, you don't have the rain protection. But alright, let's bring in all of my images. Yeah, I think people have really used them, it's just they have enough downsides that there's not really... Or they have more downsides than benefits, I assume. Because you have to worry about, like, the complicated engineering of, like, how do you make the person not tip over inside of it. Let's do, like, that size. And then I'll just blow this one up so it's pixelated. I forgot this was the image that I chose. This is... I guess it shows... It lays bare the actual, like, mechanism of connecting this. See, yeah, definitely the tricky part is going to be to understand... Have like this here, then it goes down like that, and it kind of like seamlessly goes into this almost. We have like a little like flow out this way. Put all these, so these are the motorcycles. Oh. There we go. I'm trying to think how to best capture the movement, the aesthetic of the of this style and age of motorcycle. There's definitely these swoops and these like lines here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the single wheels could be interesting, especially for like I suppose for like a science fiction thing where like the precision that's required is not as bad as like the materials that you save from using such a like minimalist vehicle with the one wheel. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I think they've been something that people have been experimenting with for a long time. Because I've also seen a few other prototypes. So let's see. So yeah, this... Hmm. That's certainly, like, the gist of it. Well, that's actually... So this is... Motorcycle. Ideas that Rita. And this one's going to be more or less the same. It has a bit more of a straight line this way. Well, I did sort of exaggerate the curves there. I would definitely use this shape of light. And like that sort of shape of instrument for this. This here and then this here. I don't really need to trace any of this, but I want to. Well, admittedly, tracing these circles is going to make me look dumb when I turn this on and it looks terrible. Yeah, they don't also... Yeah, that's good enough. This gets the gist better than with the circle in here. Then there's just too many lines. And the exhaust. That's another thing that I should think about. How does the exhaust system work? Ah, interesting. So that's going to be a big difference aesthetically. I need more dirt bikes, because I think the dirt bike is going to be the complicated element to work in here. Yeah, let's get a more traditional, like, dirt bike in here. Yeah, I suspect this has the same mech, or like, layout as this, broadly. Where the exhaust is like going from here into here, so that way there's as little as possible attached to the back tire. Yeah, I'm gonna need some... Ooh, I like this. Let's see... So... Oh, missing the seat. That's a crucial bit of the silhouette here. Okay. So yeah, definitely the gist of that Harley Davidson, like, old style motorbike look. Wait, how did this... Oh, wait, I see. Okay. This needs to be in there. I don't understand how it's not working. There we go. And then these motorbikes have a completely different, like, design language, like almost the opposite, because you have like the triangle that goes down like this way. Yeah, because these are designed for like, oh, and that makes complete sense, I just realized, because the suspension needs to go like a foot to handle like jumps and things. So we'll want something sort of in between the like very, in fact, I think this one doesn't have any front suspension at all, it looks like, almost. I mean, I don't see no springs. There's probably a spring somewhere in there, but it's probably like on the order of inches, like this one here, where there's like probably like 2 inches of travel, if that. Good lord, for spending so much of my life, like, I grew up around dirt bikes so much, I did not realize just how, like, ugly this is. Like, look at this thing. Look at this. Look, it's like a... It's like, you compare the, like, just the gist of it, it's like, wow. Look at the elegance, look at the grace. Oh, wait, I accidentally drew on top of it. Oh, well. And here it's like... It's very much a machine with a purpose. So yeah, this will be an interesting needle to try to thread. Kickstand, which I guess, yeah, I guess it probably influences the silhouette. So I suppose this is also an interesting look at an alternative. Or like a more aesthetic, or an attempt at an aesthetic. I guess that's the big difference between, since this was searching dirt bike, this was searching off-road motorcycle. Oh, I guess another thing that's not helping this thing is the fact that it's off the ground, so the suspension is completely suspended as much as it can be. So like if you probably... Let's see, because yeah, if we played with this a little bit, we'd get it looking a little bit nicer by, for example, taking this, putting it at the pivot point, bringing it down a little bit, and then like grabbing this. Putting that there. That brings it more in line with what you would want from a... Well, what you would have is... Well, what it would actually look like. I need to redo these lines here. Okay, which lines did I forget? Where did I put... No, there's the pen. Okay. Let's get this to, like, there. Get that. Do that. So now I can see which lines I've messed up. this coming this way. And this also. There we go. So now, we have some nice motorcycles. This one does look kind of cool. Well, kind of cool. It just looks good. I don't need to qualify it with kind ofs. And this one has... It also has a very interesting, like, hunchback look. You know, like, you would physically be hunched over riding this, you know, on this thing. Well, I suppose, yeah. I'll stand by that. So it does have some interesting bits on the front. Or like, all these like tubes and things that kind of alter the silhouette. I guess it's very like modern, like sci-fi almost aesthetic, where like breaking up the silhouette with these bits and parts. Where these ones, they try to maintain a very specific flowing silhouette, and this one is so simple that it doesn't have room to, like, add bits and bobs like this one. But, like, the most that it... Like, the biggest departure is, like, this. Like, this is the only, like, weird departure from the silhouette. It's not even... It's more just from, like, a pure functional standpoint of just needing to be there. So, yeah, it's definitely, like... This is the luxury motorcycle for the modern era. I do like this big, long, honking horn of a exhaust pipe. See, now assume the seat goes like this without this bag here. This is a major contributor to the silhouette, or like an internal silhouette, basically. And then we have this fancy gizmo. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, that's the gist of it. I'd say this little bit. Kind of an important bit. Okay. Admittedly, all I've done for the past several minutes is just trace over some motorcycles. Hmm. Yeah, if I had to make a motorcycle that looked like this but drove like this. Let's get a new color. Let's do a dark purple-ish. Darkish purple. Well, now let's do red. I can't see the difference between blue and purple. Okay, so if we started from this silhouette here, had a little seat like that. Then clearly we'd have the handles go like this, but we would need them to go much further. We would need this to be suspended a bit further up. Let's move this thing. There we go. So if we needed this to come up so that we have a separate mechanism here, so it should be relatively almost parallel with the ground. In fact, I bet it would, in fact, yeah, if this were on the ground, it'd be actually parallel, and this one's almost parallel as well. We'd have something like this. And so we'd probably have, like, the engine here. And that would go behind the seat. Let's get this. Let's get a little rectangle in here. So I would want this to still be almost tangent here. Because this will be to get the dust away from us. Or I suppose you could have the wheel. Like, you could have this dust cover, or dust wheel well, attached by the suspension. Or attached on this side to the wheel. Rather than attaching it to the bike like this one does, which I think would look... It would match better the sensibilities of me. Now the question is, something that I'd like is this. Or I like a gentle, like, curve. So what if we had something come out like this? So it's, like, hinged here, and then maybe there's more internal mechanisms like this. I mean, this sort of explains why you would have the seat just continue back this way. But who knows? Maybe just have it like a... Well... You could just have that there. Then you have a wheel well. You have a different, like, material here. Or no, you just have, so like, this bit here, I need a different color. Let's do, I guess just blue. So this bit would all be one assembly, or one moving piece. And then the suspension would be like here, maybe. And that gets the gist of it. I'll have to think more. I'll have to do some better sketches. Swishes insists it'd be, if I wanted this to actually look good, I'd have to have, like, the suspension animated, I'd say. Which I guess wouldn't be that bad. Yeah, because I just have, like, two animations in, with two key, or like, four keyframes, basically, of, like, this up, this down, this up, this down. And then you just decide which one is up and which one is down based on aesthetic. Interesting to think about. Well, let's do... I think that'll be a fun little project to do off stream. Animation... Or let's do, like, get... Anim. Star.import. Okay. Reduce error margin for base movements. Various fixes again. I wonder, does that count as a nonsense commit message? I mean, it's certainly an unhelpful commit message, so I'll say it's in the spirit of it. Well... Oh, it stopped working. Why did the button stop? Oh wait, no. It didn't stop working. I just need that. There we go. Do I have anything I'd want to put on the bingo card to make a bingo card? Nah, that's sort of against the spirit of bingo. I think you lost bingo today. You don't get any bingo. Because it's meant for things that I do on accident. Now let's push. Okay. I'll say that'll be it for today. Because as fun as it would be to spend all night drawing a motorcycle, I'm not going to. Though I will probably come back to that tomorrow, since... Well, I should probably come back to, like, the mechanics of it tomorrow. No, not tomorrow. Wednesday. I'm doing Monday, Wednesday, Friday now. And I'm gonna be doing work off-stream Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday if I feel like it. Because that'll all be, like, the spoilery writing stuff, and you'll get all the scraps that I can't think of. But okay. Thanks for stopping by. See you later.